Pacific got going when one of the Zawangas smoked a San Jose State receiver, and that got everybody else cranked up. And when that kind of thing happens, people are going to start scratching their head and go, you know, I really don't want to get hit like that. I mean, that's just the way it is. It becomes contagious on your team, and on the other side of the team, you can't find an antibiotic because you can't hide from guys that want to take you apart.
Well, there's the key to victory from Kurt Heinrich. We got to leave those Aggies scratching in their heads and thinking and scratching some more. We'll be back for the beginning of today's game between the New Mexico State Aggies and the UOB Tigers.
Tiger.
short kickoff, so the Aggies will start out about their own 27-yard line. Manns was averaging 27 yards a return. Gilchrist made the initial hit of the ball game. He comes out. First chance for the Tiger fans to see a little bit different look in the secondary. Both, not both, but Waspo Zawanga playing. Yeah, both Zawangas in the game right now. Tigers come out in a nickel defense right away. Something they haven't used early in a game like this. Ledbetter calls signals, slot formation. He's going to throw it right away. He wants Davis. He's got Davis at the 37. Stoops will make the tackle, run him out of bounds. It'll be a gain of about 11, maybe 12. Looks like 12 on the mark out to the 39-yard line.
Well, you appropriately said that the Tigers came out in a nickel package, which means that they've got five defensive backs, and we talked about how to get after the quarterback. They came from the secondary, came with one of the Sewango brothers to try to get to Ledbetter. He didn't get there.
Coteau, number 28, Waspa, number 34, Zawanga. Brian McGinnis, number 31, at one corner. Aggies again in a slot formation, three wide receivers. I understand, I'm not positive, they only ran the ball six times 2 weeks ago. Ledbetter sets up, five-step drop, looking to the right, throws it, it's complete, gain of about 9.5 yards to Tony Sanchez, and he's another Laney College kid out of the East Bay. He makes the catch, it is 9, it's out just short of the 49-yard line, so Ledbetter starts out hot as a pistol, 2 for 2.
No pressure on him, five-step drop, throwing a 10-yard out, and it's pretty easy when you got a corner that's giving a lot of ground. The linebacker's not getting underneath it.
Spragan comes in as a late substitute. Both Zawangas come out. Kilgris comes in. Looks like some confusion in the defensive set. They're going to play double coverage here. Going to give the ball. Manns play action fake. No, Ledbetter. Lots of time to throw. Over the middle. Sean Manuel. Crossing pattern. First down. Burton makes the initial contact, but it's a gain all the way down to the Tiger 35-yard line.
New Mexico State's offense right now has got the Tigers on their heels going backwards. Nice play action pass that time by Cody Ledbetter. Sold it very well and then throws the ball into the secondary.
Well, Ledbetter looks to me about 7 or 8 pounds lighter than he was a couple of years ago, Kurt. He seems to be moving around better. Has a beautiful play action fake on the bootleg. Two wide receivers, two tight ends in the game. Manuel, the young man from Laney in Pinole Valley. Manns, counter action, gets hit behind the line of scrimmage. Burke makes the initial contact. Bill Denny brings him down. We've got a late block by Davis on Burton. Let's see which way they call it. A penalty flag at the Tiger 28-yard line after the Tigers make a nice tackle for a little bit of a loss.
It's a super job by Elliot Burke. He saw the counter coming and absolutely stuffed the guard that was pulling out in front of him to push the play inside so the linebackers can make the tackle.
Personal foul, face mask against Burton. Now, Burton has been a young man the last couple of weeks. We call this in Southwest Louisiana. Gets a little bit caught up in some extracurricular activity. Guys blocking on him. If they know he reacts in the scouting report, they're going to take a shot at him. So the Tigers get a 15-yard penalty right away after a nice defensive stop by Bill Denny with help from Elliot Burke. And as a result, it'll be a first down inside the Tiger 21-yard line on the right hash. 13:49 and counting. In the first quarter, the Aggies have looked real good until the last offensive play, and Burton helps them 15 more. Davis and Sanchez stay in the game. Patterson in the slot. Ledbetter blitzes on. Zawanga after him. Screen. Manns. Nice play. 20 to the left. 15. And Boswell Zawanga makes the hit. Runs him out of bounds about the 13.5-yard line. It'll be a gain of 7.5. Second and 2.5.
I tell you what, that was a pretty good play call in the face of a blitz by New Mexico State, but the Tigers' defense did a fine job rallying to the football not to give up even more yards than they did.
You heard Chuck Shelton, if you heard the pregame show, said as a young man, his defense felt that Ledbetter started out hot, he'd stay hot. If he got to him early, roughed him up a little bit, he had problems. Well, the Tigers haven't come close to him yet. Slot formation again. Manns is the tailback. Give him the ball. Off right tackle, cuts back against the grain, and he'll score standing up. Burke misses the tackle at the 7, and Mann simply started a right tackle, cut back at the center spot, and went right down the left hash for a touchdown, standing up. 12:42 to go in the first quarter. Aggies score first at 6-0.
Yeah, New Mexico State went through them like a hot knife through butter. Pacific's defense, they tried to do some things to get to the quarterback, they just couldn't get there. They came off the corner, they brought their linebacker, but the Aggie offensive line did a fine job.
broken blocking assignment there for sure, Kurt, because he was going to stay inside the tackle if he could.
Yeah, and it was designed to stay inside the tackle. Joe tried to get the corner, just did not have the quicks at this point in the game. And again, I think he does his most damage between the tackles, and then later on in the game, he will turn that corner.
Tigers with a chance to play for the Las Vegas Bowl if they can win today and then go on and keep on winning out against Nevada and then at Utah State. Lee calls signals, line of scrimmage about the 3-yard line. He rolls left, buying time, lots of time, going to throw it, and he throws it away. It looked like that ball just got away from him. He didn't look quite like the same kid as he did last week, and maybe the fumble upset him a little bit, but that ball not near anybody. So it'll be fourth down, and John Fassel, who's done a great job filling in for Roger Fleener, comes in to punt, but this will be his first collegiate punt out of an end zone, Kurt.
Yeah, and Graham Lee has been in third and long, and that's not what you want your freshman quarterback to be
so
in.
So Fassel, with his right heel as close to that back line of the end zone as you can get, will try to kick. He's averaging 32.7 a punt. Lucius Davis stands at the Tiger 46-yard line now. Fassel with plenty of time. He hits it off the side of his foot, the worst punt of his career, and it hits about the 28. It bounces backwards and is fielded at the 27 by Mike Morales. So the young man obviously nervous. This is a kid, before everybody gets excited, who's done a great job. That's his first poor punt. He had never kicked in high school or college. Fleener got hurt. Abdullah had punted some, but it injured his hamstring doing it. They didn't want to take a chance, and this kid's done a good job. Racing back up and just stepping right over Marty Conrad and stumbled. I think he probably hit Conrad's shoulder pad with his lead foot. Two tight ends back in the game again. Charles Birdwell, the redshirt sophomore, is in along with Manuel. Play action fake. Ledbetter rolls out, wants to throw in the flat. He's got Manuel. Burton misses him. He's going to score a touchdown. Steve Wright hits him at the two, but he lunges in. Nigel Burton had him at the 8-yard line and let him get away.
Yeah, Nigel Burton, a freshman, a guy who plays the ball very well in the secondary, has a nose for the football. However, his tackling ability clearly is suspect, but that will get better with age.
So, 8:16 to go in the first quarter. Aggies score again. They lead 13-0.
The frustrating thing is the Tigers are in position to make plays. They're not making the plays.
I agree with you. Coolin to try his PAT. And you can't give a team that was ready to come in here and not play well a chance to play well because they get the lead. The kick is blocked. It's a low snap. It's blocked by the middle of the Tiger line. And about four guys run after the football and kind of fall on it and on each other. And Burton just hit a guy in the back again. No penalty that time. Could have been a personal foul right there after the play.
And the official walked with them for about 5 yards talking to him.
We'll be right back. the score. The PAT was no good. New Mexico State 13, Tigers nothing.
What you've done is given these Aggies a lot of life. They would have come in here and laid down if Pacific had jumped on them right away. As a result, we're going to be in a shootout, we hope. It's a high end-over-end kick. Whatley gets it 3 yards deep, and he kneels on the ball. He will not run it out, so Tigers will take over on their own 20-yard line. Even Coolin is kicking the ball now.
Yeah, New Mexico State, I mean, you couldn't have said it any better, Bob. I mean, that's exactly the prescription so far, is that New Mexico State, a team that has to, you know, I mean, you need to take a steamer, a wagon train to get here to Stockton, so it's not easy travel plan for them. However, they come out, they've got 13 points on the board, and the Tigers have been three and out in both their series.
Tigers come out, three wide receivers right away. This was a great running formation against San Jose State last week. Looks like it to be a passing situation in it. No, it's a draw. Abdullah, he's going to cross the 20 and out to the 22. Gain of two. Speaking of San Jose State, they trail Arkansas State 7-0 at the half. In other games with Big West opponents involved, Nevada leads early in the third quarter at Utah State 16-13. Stanford over SC in the first quarter, Kurt, 6-0 in the Coliseum. Tigers come out, 2nd and 8. Ball inside the right hash, about 2 steps at the 22-yard line. Ramley's gone all the way at quarterback. Justin Worth is the center. Chu and Weldon are the guards. Play action fake. Ramley does a nice job of moving around and throws the ball away. Boy, it looked like defensive pass interference there. It wasn't a catchable ball to Blakeney. It'll be 3rd and 8.
It's tough to fool people if you have not established the run when you go with the play-action fake. The Tigers have not established Joe Abdullah, so therefore the linebackers aren't really adhering to the run game.
So now it's 3rd and 8, and we're still 7:30 to go in the first quarter. Tigers don't get something going here. Aggies are going to have the ball for the third time.
Unofficially, the Aggies with over 100 yards offensively, the Tigers with negative yards so far in the football game. 7:30 to go in the first quarter.
Watley wide into the sidelines. Atkins wide to the left at the slot spot. Bowers outside of him. Gramley looks like he calls an audible here. Let's see if he does. Sets up, wants to throw. Big rush is on. He hits Ryan Green right in the hands. He drops the ball as he's hit. The ball goes up in the air and falls to the ground before the Aggies can get there. Watley really upset. He thought he had the ball. He had a shot at the ball, too.
Well, Watley's also against a guy on the corner, Jeffrey Thompson, who is a freshman.
True freshman.
Yeah, at 6'2", 182. I think you kind of look for some mismatches here and take advantage of that type of situation for Pacific.
So here you got Fassel for his second punt of the game. The last one was just about, what was it, 17 yards, Bob, I think, off the side of his foot. They don't rush him. And he does it again. He hits a wobbly kick that hits it to Tiger 49 and rolls out of bounds. Kilgris downs it about the Tiger 47. So a 25-yard punt. And John Fassel, who has punted so well, just off his game right now.
Yeah, he's dropping the ball like you would out in the front yard. It doesn't look like his form is the way it was in the first two contests when he was called upon to do the punting duties. Now he's kind of reverting like you go at halftime of the Super Bowl and you go outside and start punting a little bit.
Davis into the sidelines. Garcia wide right. Dwayne Gregory, a 6'1", 190 sophomore, now in at the slot. Delvis Manns in at the tailback. Denvis Manns, excuse me. Little tiny guy. Ledbetter sets up. Wants Davis. He's going to underthrow it. The ball was nearly intercepted by Stukes out in the flat. A nice play by Ray Stukes. An awful long time for Ledbetter to throw. But again, a little bit of happy feet, huh, Kurt?
Yeah, it threw off his back foot. That's why the ball was a little bit tardy to the outside. Stukes was able to get back into it. When Ledbetter can step up and throw the ball, I don't know that the Tigers are going to be able to drive on the out and knock it down. He has that kind of arm strength. However, he does not have the kind of arm strength that he can throw off his back foot and get it there on time.
2nd and 10, ball on the left hash just outside the Tiger 46-yard line. Manns gets confused, moves to his right, then back to his left. Draw, Manns, running room, 45, 40, and he's hit, lunges forward, close to a first down around the 37-yard line. Waswa Zawaga in on the hit, along with Burton late. Nice running, this kid is quick.
Yeah, and he doesn't go backwards when he's first engaged. He gets another 2-3 yards after he's hit.
Tigers a little confused on defense. Now they
is a running back. He is a freshman. They have him listed at 5'9", 186. So you got to believe he's probably about 5'7", 5'8", 180 at best. So, I mean, he's not going to run you over. You have to stay up tall, get big on a running back of that size.
Nose of the football just touching the 35-yard line, about 4 yards inside the right hash. So nearly the middle of the field. Two tight ends, two wide receivers in the game. Aggies go back and forth between this formation and three wides. Ledbetter, play action fake. It's a nice one. He rolls right. He can run with this football. Changes his mind. Throws it downfield. It's complete. 1 foot in, 1 foot out. That's Tony Sanchez, a young man from Laney. It's clear down inside the Tiger 20-yard line, and Ledbetter was a lot of time to throw, but he's walking backwards. Was he over the line of scrimmage there, or a receiver was? Ineligible receiver downfield. Tigers get a break.
Well, they sort this out. Final score already in from Utah. Nevada defeating Utah State this afternoon by the final score of 30-25. So Nevada keeps on their winning ways.
But a close score and an indication that the Tigers will have their work cut out for them in 2 weeks, Bob Caresco, November 18th. Season regular season final in Logan, Utah against the Aggies. We'll be on the air for the kickoff that day at 11 a.m. It's a 12 o'clock local time kickoff. Pre-game show will be 10:30.
Play those games early before Bigfoot comes out. Everybody wants to get home.
Three wides in the game again this time for the Aggies. Ledbetter calls the play at the line of scrimmage. You can see him doing it. Tigers show blitz, then they start to walk away. Wants to go. Blitz patterns are on. It's thrown underneath. It's going to be complete down to about the Tiger 32, maybe 33-yard line. That's Gregory on the catch. McGinnis makes the hit. Gain of about four on the play. Maybe three. Put it back at the 32. What this does, though, is you keep the longer you keep that defense on the field, the more it wears on them, too, in the second half, and the more Joe Abdullah can't get the football to wear down their defense.
That's
5:28 to go in the quarter. Ball in the left hash. Second and seven at the Tiger 32 for the Aggies. Ledbetter calls signals. Looks like a lot of listen to me, Kurt. Changing plays all the time. Sets up three steps. Wants to throw a turn. He's got it complete to 22. And by the time McGinnis kind of wraps him around and throws him down, that's 18. Patterson, that's a backup redshirt freshman, makes the catch. It's all the way down the 15-yard line. Poor tackling after the catch.
Well, it's also too easy on the outside. The Tigers cornerbacks are given 10 and 12 yards on the outside. And New Mexico State, you said, check with me. He's just running the out. And he's picking the shortest side, shortest amount of time the ball has to be in the air. It's very easy reception.
Got a quick little guy, Roderick Payne, in the game. He's been in for a couple plays now. 5'8", 166-pound junior from Dallas. I bet he can fly, it looks like. Ledbetter wants to throw the fade. Davis, touchdown! McGinnis never saw the ball. Davis with a touchdown catch, his ninth of the year, and already it's 19-0, and we've barely played 11 minutes.
New Mexico State probably having to go for two here to try to get that point back, but they...
Look at the Tigers just walking around.
They're going through them pretty easily here in the first quarter.
And they are going to go for two. You're right, Kurt. And we now know he can't throw the fade. Touch.
Yeah, and he threw it on a line. That was the thing.
Man's play action fake. Ledbetter in the flat. Throws it out of the back of the end zone. But there's a penalty flag down. Let's see what's going on.
Have to wonder if the Tigers were in the neutral zone.
Ah, jeez. You're right, Kurt. Penalty against the Tigers. Come on, Pacific. Let's wake up and get going here.
Offsides against the Tigers.
Offsides. Jeez. Going to run the ball here now. Watch. Ball's on the yard and a half line.
Well, the thing is, they have not made Cody Ledbetter squeeze some passes in there that are tough for a quarterback. They've given him the boundary, and he's played the sidelines perfectly with the out pattern.
Kirk Compton in the game at the fullback spot. Two tights and a wing. Let's see if Compton gets the ball or Ledbetter just keeps it himself. Play action fake, gives it to Mans. He gets stood up and he won't get there. Nice defensive surge that time. Stukes in on the hit. Totola in on the hit. Burton in on the hit. See who made the initial. So we'll break in the action. The score, New Mexico State 19, Pacific nothing. We'll be right back. Off. Reeder and Watley deep. The ball is drilled. Reeder's going to get it. About the 4, maybe the 5. Up the right side. Cuts to the outside. It's hit about the 18. Doesn't get a block from the up back Watley. And he's downed about the maybe the 19-yard line on forward progress.
Well, on a lazy Indian summer afternoon, the Tigers come out playing that way. In fact, they look a lot like General Custer's crew. As right now, it's New Mexico State up on top 19-0. 7-play, 47-yard drive, took 2 minutes and 30 seconds off the clock. Ledbetter to Lucius Davis for the final chunk, 19-0. They went for 2, no good.
Tigers come out. Graham Lee is the quarterback. Blakeney at the up-back spot. Greg Weston in at the slot. Jake Hoford in at the wide receiver spot. Going to give the ball to Abdullah. He fumbles it, picks it up. Going to lose some yards. And somehow doesn't. Lunges back all the way to the 19-yard line. Tigers just do not look insane. They look fired up before the game started, Kurt. Last week, I thought they were flat in the pregame against San Jose. Didn't come out and play real well, and then got it going and really played well. They're not doing it. They look good in pregame warm-up today.
Yeah, but when they blew the whistle, they have not looked good, either on defense or so far on offense. So they've got to figure out a way to get something going, and that means first downs.
Slot formation again. Weston and Hoford to wide receivers. Abdullah straight ahead. He's going to gain about 3, maybe 4, maybe even 5 now out to the 24 as Joe lunges forward.
Today's game is sponsored by AirTouch Cellular, the closest distance between two people, AirTouch Cellular, and by the Bank of Stockton. 128 years sets us a history apart from the rest. Bank of Stockton, member FDIC.
Remember the movie Psycho, Kurt? Were you old enough to ever see that?
I saw
Mommy
that.
Let you stay up afterwards. You have nightmares?
Yes.
Well, Janet Lee was the woman in the shower that got killed, and she'll be here on November 13th for a special appearance to benefit the library. We'll talk about that in a minute. Weston in motion. Graham Lee rolls left, got some time, drills it, throws it behind Weston and behind Hoford at the same time. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down, and he's not even close on that one.
No, and he had Weston, too, for the first down. They gave him a three-level look to the wide side of the field. The Tigers had a receiver open, but Graham Lee couldn't find him.
So now Fassel has to punt again, a young man who shanked 2 already. Tigers with such an exciting victory to build off of last week. Come out here, 3:09 to go in the first quarter. Aggies will get the ball for the 4th time today already. Snap is a little high. This time it's a knuckleball. It's going to hit at the Aggie 40 and roll down about the 37. Somebody down it. Steve Wright does at the 37-yard line. The crowd cheers because the ball's not sliced. 39 yards, no return.
Well, I think offensively, Bob, so far the Tigers, they've gone to the air more than you'd like them to. Joe Abdullah has to get on track. He's going to take a lot of pressure off of Graham Lee. And we saw it on the last play before the errant pass. He got about 5 yards, and there was no penetration. Defensively, you have to challenge the cornerbacks and take away the 10-yard outs.
They're going to challenge him now in a bump and run. Zawanga's both back in. 5 defensive backs in the game again. Aggies play action. Nope, he sets up. Going to throw the swing out. Demands. One-on-one with Totola. He beats Totola. Ryan McGinnis kind of makes the tackle, brings him down. It'll be a gain of about 8 out to the 45. Aggies virtually doing whatever they want right now.
Well, they did there, but again, the play should have been stopped after about 3 yards because there was a defender there to make the tackle. So, again, when the plays are there to be made, the players have to make it. The Tigers have been in the right defense. They're just not executing.
Yeah, but you're asking a lot of a linebacker or cornerback out there with one-on-one coverage on a catch to make a play out there. That's a pretty tough play.
Davis in the slot to the left.
He's a tackler. That's what he does.
Second and two. Ball at the Aggie 45 on the right hash. Ledbetter again calls a play at the line of scrimmage. Tiger's going to blitz. Can't quite get there. Throws complete. Out to the Tiger 46-yard line. That's Dwayne Gregory again. First down at the Tiger 46. McGinnis on the hit tackle.
Can't quite get there, but they're getting closer. They are indeed getting closer. The rush is getting a little bit more in Cody Ledbetter's face. The thing that you have to avoid is for the score to get so out of reach that your offense is having to throw every down, and then you take Joe Abdul out of it.
Well, I don't think you do that this early in the game still. Still in the first quarter, 1:50 and counting. First and 10, ball at step inside the left hash. Ledbetter changes the play again. Draw. Man's got running room, 40, 35, and down to about the 33-yard line. He wasn't even touched till he got to the 35. First down again for the Aggies.
Tigers manning up on the outside, and that means their linebackers are manning up. The New Mexico State offensive line doing a good job releasing the front four and then getting on top of the UOP linebackers in order for Mann to get the first down.
McGinnis wanted out of the game. They wouldn't let him out. Look at him. What's wrong with him? McGinnis, number 31, lines up in a bump on Garcia. Sanchez into the sidelines. Ledbetter sets up, wants to throw that swing outside. Bill Denny can't make the play. He's there as Mans cuts back inside, gets down to about the 30-yard line. We'll call it a gain of 3, second and 7.
Unofficially, New Mexico State with just under 200 yards offensively on the afternoon. The Tigers with a net of 5.
That's ugly. We're still in the first quarter.
53 seconds to go in that quarter, second and 7. Ball just touching the 30-yard line on the right hash. McGinnis goes back in, started to come out again. I don't know what his situation is. Now they tell him to get out. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Tigers have to take a timeout. And we will too. We'll be right back.
down, I think they almost have to go for it, don't you? It'll be fourth and one. Some late hitting going on. That was Adrian Lomas. He's a 6'4", 250-pound senior from Golden West Junior College. He and Mike Morales mixing it up. The Tigers are going to go for it.
I believe it's only third down, isn't it?
Nope. Abdullah gained 8 on first down. Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. Getting ahead of myself here. I've had enough fourth downs today. Third and one. Abdullah with that carry before the end of the quarter. Thank you for coming back.
Well, you're
after refreshing yourself.
You're still caught up in the shower scene.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. Frank Jordan and Janet Lee and Anthony Perkins all together. Two tights in a game. Bowers at the wing back. Blakeney. Play action fake. They throw the ball in the flat. Abdullah, 45, 40. Out of bounds at the 39-yard line on a third and one. And a nice fake by Graham Lee and Kerry Blakeney.
That's an early gutsy call by Bill Bliles, the offensive coordinator. I mean, how do you go away from Joe Abdullah at 6 foot 220 when you know he doesn't go backwards? It's the play action fake like you described, Bob, and then they go to Joe to the flat.
First down for the Tigers. Yep. First down of the game. On the 39-yard line, Graham Lee with a completion. Weston into the sidelines. He caught a 20-yarder last week for a score. Graham Lee sets up, wants to throw the turn. He's got it. Watley, 28, breaks a tackle inside the 25. Down to the 24-yard line. We'll call it 15 more. He drilled a rope there, Kurt.
And let me tell you why the curl pattern is so effective for this offense when you have Joe Abdul in the backfield, because the linebackers have to step up and play run. They absolutely have to. And then when they realize that it's a play pass, then they drop in the coverage. It's too late. The receiver opens up, and the ball is in the air, in route.
Are you going to do that boring thing about the greatest pattern in football is the curl again, like you do every week? Pretty soon.
Okay, it's the greatest pattern.
Three wide receivers in the game. Ball in the right hash. Aggie, 24. Play action, fake. Beautiful fake by Lee. He can run. And he cuts to the outside, inside the 20, and runs out of bounds about the 17. We'll call it the 16 and a half, a gain of 8. And that's the athleticism we talked about a week ago, folks. If you haven't seen this kid play, he can make a lot of things happen with his feet.
And he got a nice block by Mike Morales on the outside so he could pick up another 5 yards and get him close to the first down.
13:38 to go in the half. Tigers trail by 19, but they're knocking on the door with a second and two at the 16-and-a-half-yard line.
Makes it a lot easier with second down and 2 and 3 yards to go.
You notice that?
I always do.
It's like not hitting with 0 and 2, huh? Blakeney back in the game at the fullback spot. Morales stays in at the tight end. Graham Lee, Abdullah, right side, gets through. It'll be close to a first down. I think he's got it.
Oh, yeah.
It is a first down. The crowd starts to come alive a little bit.
And if it was the boxing vernacular, that's what you call a body punch.
First
Joe Abdullah
Pacific
goes inside, and at 220, when he gets about 5 yards steam, head of steam going, that's going to take it out of your defense.
You were kind of into that last week at San Jose with that Kent Norton Jr. imitation every time the Tigers.
I got a little excited.
You made me nervous. I thought you were going to hit me. Three wide receivers in the game. They're all wide to the left. Ball in the right hash. Abdullah gets the ball. Left tackle. Makes his own hole. He get down to about the 10. In fact, it'll be a little short of the 10. Let's see where they give forward progress. That closed up in a hurry. Looked like he had a lot more running room there. Last week at San Jose, we talked about it, folks, if you heard. It seemed like Abdullah gained 2 and he really gained 6 or 7 because that big offensive line was surging forward so much, especially late in the game, as Kurt was talking about, because they took control of the line of scrimmage. And I would say a devastating loss to the San Jose program.
Yeah, and especially as you see the score today on the road.
7-0 at the half at Arkansas State, a game that San Jose should win.
The final was 21-7 Arkansas State, by the way.
Oh, it did come in. We didn't see that. Graham Lee sets up, wants to throw, lots of time underneath, and that ball's deflected and knocked backwards over his head back to about the 25-yard line, and he had Watley at the 3.
Yeah, he did. Watley had come clean over the middle. The ball was there, just knocked down at the line of scrimmage.
So it'll be third down at the Aggie 11, we'll call it, 10-and-a-half, third and about 7. Tigers have got to go in, call it even 8, Kurt, is where their markers are. first field goal attempt as a Tiger in this stadium. He hit a field goal at Southwest Louisiana. This will be about a 27-yarder from dead center of the field.
Yeah, that play didn't look like it was designed or executed very well.
McSwinney was going to redshirt. He's a freshman from Nevada Union High School. Nick Sellers to hold. The snap is good. And he hits a line drive, but it's through the upright. Boy, he hit a knuckleball, and he stomped his foot, but it's good. So it's 19-3, 12:21 to go in the half. We'll break, and we'll be right back.
the line and twists forward, and he's real close to the first down at the Tiger 42. Bill Denny in on the tackle. Can't see who the other black shirt is that gets up. Bruno is in on the hit also.
But the thing is, when you engage a guy that's a buck 80, he cannot drive a linebacker another yard and pick up a first down. And that's what he's doing. Granted, there's some leverage there, but still, he's given away a good 40 pounds.
First and 10 for the Aggies. They don't even measure it. It was across the 42 when all the bodies uncurled. Two wide receivers, two tights in the game. Tigers show blitz, then back away on the audible. Ledbetter sets up, plenty of time. Going to get nailed by Burke. He completes it to Manuel. Kilgross makes the hit about the Tiger 37-yard line. McLaughlin makes the tackle, excuse me. Well, no, that's 82. That's Manuel. I'm right on the initial call.
You're sharp today. You are sharp today.
Yeah. Stanford leading number 14 USC at the half, 24-17. Oregon over Washington, 24-8 in the third quarter.
At Washington.
And Northwestern leading Penn State in the third quarter, 14-10. Good for the Mildcats. They're not mild anymore. Second and five. Ball at the left hash at the Tiger 37-yard line. Ledbetter again calling the play at the line of scrimmage. Blitz is on. He's got Burke on his backside. Bruno chasing him. He's going to throw the ball downfield. He finds an open receiver at the 20, and it's Gregory, and he's inside the 10 down to the 9-yard line. So Ledbetter buying time, scrambling out of the pocket on the blitz, completes the ball to Gregory, caught it on a turn at the 20, took it down to the 9.
Elliot Burke got held bad on the backside, or he would have had the sack.
Duncan into the game, Kendall out.
Left side tackle. Elliot Burke had a speed rush from the outside. He was on the quarterback, but just couldn't get there.
Spragan comes back into the game, so does Kilgross. Ledbetter coming to Stockton with both six guns loaded as he is just lining it up, throwing the football. He's already got two touchdowns on the afternoon and a heck of a completion record. Tight formation. They're going to run a play action fake. Burke right in Ledbetter's face, and he gets the ball away somehow. It's incomplete, but Burke with a nice tackle on Ledbetter as he released the football. Wish Elliott wouldn't help him up.
The competitive spirit.
I always took the hand up from the guys because you don't want to make them mad because they're going to be back there again sometime. Ball was almost completed in the end zone, just a little bit wide of the intended receiver diving for the ball. Yeah, that was number 87, who was their third tight end, James Jones. He's a junior, 6'4", 247. He's even heavier than Manuel. The ace back. He was out for a couple plays taking a rest. Watch him. See if they split. Try to split it. Blitz on. Draw. He's got running room. Runs into the back of his own offensive guard and is downed from behind by Zawanga about the 7-yard line. It'll be third and goal.
And Burton. Burton in on the tackle.
Nebraska defeating Iowa State today. Number one Nebraska, 73-14. Where was that? In Lincoln, I think.
That's right.
73-14. Tiger fans, your kids didn't do too bad back there. Run up a lot of points on a lot of people. Third and goal. Ledbetter calls signals. Three wides in the game. Sanchez to the right. Davis in the slot. He's the one you need the help on. Looked like movement by the left tackle. Jamie Daniels is right there. Ledbetter throws the ball in the end zone as Daniels knocks him to the ground at the 20. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down. Coolin comes in. He's 4-for-10 on field goals this year.
Ledbetter was knocked down on that drive five times. Five times the Tigers got to him and put him on the ground.
Tigers got a chance here. They got to just get going, pick it up a little bit. This is a team they can beat. They can score on them. They can move the ball, but they've got to come out and with a little fire. 8:41 to go in the half. Coolin, this will be about a 23-and-a-half yarder. Zeka, the punter, who hasn't had to work at all today except on holds, will hold. Snap is low. It's down. Coolin kicks it up, and it curves inside the right upright. It's good. The score. 8:37 to go in the half. Aggies 22, Tigers 3. We'll be right back.
I know.
with the ball when there's a lot of area around. He makes guys miss constantly.
So, Tiger offense, let's see what you can get done now here. Bowers in the slot left. Ronnie Smith wide of him. Tigers have used six different wide receivers already today. Graham Lee calls signals. Four-man defensive front for the Aggies. Blakeney in at the fullback spot. Looked like a late snap. I don't know what happened there. There was some confusion, and it's going to be against the Tigers, I can almost guarantee you.
Yeah, it looked like the center was a little slow. He didn't have the snap count.
Yeah, yep. They're just like sleepwalking here. It's a beautiful afternoon. Great day to play football. First and 15 now. Here we go with a long yardage situation. Come out. It's deathly quiet here in the stadium. Not too much to cheer about so far. Two tights, two wides, and Abdul in the game. He's going to get the ball right up the middle. Going to gain about three, maybe four, out to the 23-yard line.
I think it's fair to say that New Mexico State is keying on Joe Abdullah.
As everybody does every week.
Right.
But the Tigers haven't been in a position where they can wear somebody down yet. Another UOP alum coming back on November 18th, Saturday night, to celebrate his 75th anniversary, Dave Brubeck. Great musician. We got an officials timeout for a second. The tickets for that are $60, $45, $30, and $15 in advance through the UOP box office. That's 946-2-UOP. 946-2-UOP, having some trouble with the clock, I think. Tigers go back in the huddle. Brubeck graduated from the Conservatory of Music in 1942. That is Saturday night, the 18th. That will be in the Fay Spanos Conservatory, Fay Spanos Theater. Still have some problems. What's going on here, Kurt? 7:43 to go in the half. No announcement from the officials. Great exhibition last night after the women's game, Kurt, of the men's volleyball team. Joe Wortman celebrating his 40th birthday with an exhibition for the fans. Played a match, inter-squad match. Wonderful to watch. Lee calls signals. Play action fake. Rolls to his right, left. Plenty of time. Penalty flag down. And Lee throws the ball over Ryan Green. Incomplete.
Pass intended for Green is incomplete.
I don't know what's going on here. We're going to have a hold?
Yeah, on the backside.
Yes, we are. Jeez.
Ryan looked like he took that pattern a little bit deeper than he should have. That thing is designed to come about 15 to 20 yards across the field. He ran more of a flag or a reverse post pattern, if you will. That's tough to complete for Graham Lee.
Tigers will now have a second. I'd be surprised if the Aggies didn't take it, I should say. It'll either be third and 11 or second and half the distance to the goal, 22. From the point of the foul, is going to put it back to the 12. They've got to go to the 34, so it is second and 22. Tigers got to get something going here.
Yeah, maybe off a screen, maybe off a draw.
Three wides in the game, ball right in the middle of the field. Abdullah stays in at the running back spot. He's going to run a swing. Graham Lee in trouble. Swing out to Abdul. Manuel's right there. Sam Manuel runs him out of bounds. Maybe a gain of a half a yard on the play.
New Mexico State has done their homework this week. They have come together with a pretty good defensive package to stop the Tiger offense.
No gain on the play.
It'll be third and 22.
Third down.
Atkins in the slot. Graham Lee sets up. Plenty of time. Underneath, Abdullah got running room, got a blocker. 20, 25, 30, and nearly gets the first down. He's all the way out to the 32-yard line. 20 yards on the game. It'll be fourth down. Got a kick.
Right.
snap. It's a good one, plenty of time. And he hits a beautiful high kick. Going to come down and hit at the Aggie 37. Bounce backwards past Davis inside the 25 and down at the 20-yard line. So Johnny Fassel with a 48-yard punt. No return.
So what you need here now, Bob, is obviously you need three and out. You need the defense to rise up and try to flip-flop this field position a little bit for your offense so they're not having to go 80 yards every time. The last series, the Tigers got to Cody Ledbetter and put him on the ground five times. They're getting closer and closer.
Conrad back in the game. Sean Duncan in. Young man has played very well when he wasn't hurt. Going to give the ball to Mans. Cuts back. Wide open spaces. 25-30 and out to the 35-yard line. Geez, the hole was, you could have driven a truck through there. He started at left tackle, cut back at right guard, and he gains 15 on the run.
That was ridiculous. I mean, that was so wide open. The left tackle was nowhere to be seen. And it's hard for me to believe that a hole can be that wide open and you can't have a flag associated with it.
First down ball out of the Aggie 35-yard line. Ledbetter calls an audible again. You can see him doing it. Going to give the ball to Mans. He's outside right tackle. 40, 45, 50. And Cahuenga brings him down with help from Burton, but he's in Tiger territory, clear down to the 35-and-a-half-yard line. It's a gain of nearly 30 on the run. He's over 100, I'm sure of that. With that carry, he's got to be.
And make it look easy. Absolutely make it look easy. Tigers desperately needed to get New Mexico State three and out, backed up after a good punt. And they've just churned out two big runs. And they're, you know, the 36-and-a-half-yard line.
Ledbetter calls signals again. Sanchez into the sidelines. Blitz is on. They can't get to him. He's got a lot of time to throw. And a nice defensive play by McGinnis, knocking Gregory away from the football at the Tiger 28. And it took that type of play last week by Cahuenga to get something going. It'll be second and 10. Ledbetter a long time to throw again.
New Mexico State did an absolutely tremendous job picking up the Tiger Blitz. They brought everybody, and no one came clean to get to Cody Ledbetter.
Second and 10, ball on the Tiger 35-yard line. Ledbetter again with an audible. Tigers show blitz, then back off. Going to play zone. Ledbetter with a lot of time. Ball's deflected by Jamie Daniels or Duncan. I think it was Daniels at the line of scrimmage. Incomplete. It'll be third down.
Well, if you can't get to him, knock him down at the line of scrimmage.
Sure.
There was no penetration there by the Tigers, but they did have the presence of mind to get their arms up and knock the ball down, which forces Cody Ledbetter into a third and 10 situation. Big down here for the Tiger defense.
Davis again in the slot. Audible again. Tigers show blitz and back off. Duncan trying to get there. Ball's overthrown, intercepted, but let's see the penalty flag here. I bet they call interference on the Tigers.
They are. That's going to be the call.
Here, they needed a play. They get the interception. Bruno leaping backwards, making the interception off the deflection. Are they going to call pass interference? Somebody banged the intended receiver, Manuel. How can they call holding? It's pass interference. It's not holding. It's either the wrong indication.
Maybe he had a piece of his jersey in the route. I don't know.
He fell down. He got bumped into. Man does have 11 carries for 108 yards. I was correct. He did cross the 100-yard barrier. 10-yard penalty for holding. It's first down. Moves it into the Tigers, just short of the Tiger 25-yard line.
Just when you need a big play, you think you have one, and they throw the flag.
Yeah.
starts in motion. Fools Zerwanga going to give the ball to Mann. He almost gets tackled from behind. Said he's inside the 20, inside the 15, and down to the 13-yard line. Duncan almost had him. Berg makes the hit, and it's another first down. It's a gain of about 12, so he's at 120 yards here in the first half. We've still got 5:48 to go.
Boy, they're getting everything they want here, and I'm speaking of New Mexico State. They are running the ball well. They are throwing the ball well. Their offense is a well-oiled machine this afternoon.
I don't know about that. I guess it is. I'd say it is. We're making it look like a well-oiled machine anyway.
Ledbetter again with the audible. Cornerback blitz. Burton is tackled. They don't call it. He throws a touchdown. Davis on a post corner. Burton in on the blitz is tackled. Can't get there. Ledbetter on the touchdown pass. 13 yards, 5:20 to go. It's 28-3.
Cody Ledbetter doing everything he wants this afternoon. And so is Mann out of the backfield. That offensive line is doing an excellent job keeping off the Tiger defense from their star quarterback.
Coolin to convert now, attempt to convert out of Zeka's hold. Movement by the Aggies, I would think. Looked like it, left tackle and left guard raised up. I thought we were going to have a whale of a football game here this afternoon, Kurt.
You knew you had some offense in New Mexico State with Cody Ledbetter. I mean, he's a guy that's been around a long time and can throw the ball. But
defense allowing 35 points a game by the Aggies, too. So I thought we'd have ourselves another shootout. Now what's the matter? How many times are these guys going to stop? He wants to add time to the clock? What's he doing? Zeka to hold. This will be a 25-yarder. Kick is up for the PAT. It's good. We'll break in the action. The score with 5:20 to go in the half. Aggies 29, Tigers 3.
Party on Knowles Field, 11 a.m. at a 1:30 kickoff, a half hour earlier next week. Graham Lee in at the quarterback spot still. Going to set up, wants to throw the hitch. He's got Watley, 21, out to the 25 and out of bounds across the 25, out to the 27. First down, Tigers. sets up three steps, out and up, wants to go to Whatley, and it's past his leap at the Tiger 43-yard line. Incomplete.
Well, you had Atkins right down the middle. Sometimes when you look at one guy, I mean, it's hard to commit and not go to it.
Yeah, it was clearly a design play call.
Sure.
You throw the hitch, and then the hitch and go. Not a bad call.
Second and 10 for the Tigers. Ball just inside their 28-yard line on the left hash. Weston into the sidelines for Whatley this time. Offsides on the Aggies, it appears. Pat Dyer, a 6'1", 276-pound junior, the culprit on that. So it'll be second and 5 for the Tigers. That'll move the ball out to the 33-yard line.
The frustrating thing, Bob, is there is some things the Tigers offense can take advantage of in this New Mexico State secondary. I think the Tigers receivers are better than New Mexico State's defensive backs, yet they have not proven it. Because they're sticking with Joe Abdullah, which you expect them to do so.
Again, three wide receivers in the game. Second and 5. Bramley sets up three steps, throws outside. Atkins got it. 40, breaks a tackle. 45, 50, breaks another tackle in inside Aggie territory at the 47-yard line. 20 yards on the game. Eric Atkins with another big play.
Yeah, you have some mismatches in the slot. Clearly have a mismatch with Atkins. I don't think anybody can cover him. They haven't all season. But you also have him on the outside when you're starting a true freshman at cornerback. He's a guy you need to work over the coals a little bit. And he's on Ty Whatley right now.
Atkins and Weston wide left. Ryan Green, the tight end. Lee calls signal, sets up. Wants to throw underneath. He's got Weston on a quick screen. Delaying out, gets a block from Dan Weldon, and he's tackled about the 42-yard line. A gain of 5, second and 5.
Again, it's a lot of stuff there. It's a nice gain. It's a well-executed play, but I don't know that you need to get that tricky when you got a freshman receiver on the corner. Throw the hitch on him.
Defensive back.
On the cornerback. Make him make plays on the outside. I don't think he could play Ty Whatley.
Thompson, the young man at the far side, the east side of this field, covering Whatley. This time Whatley hitched, thrown a little quick. He couldn't see it coming out of the sun. He dropped the ball right at the first down marker at the 37-yard line. And Thompson had slipped. Whatley was going to have some running room.
Yeah. And he's quickly pulled, and they come in with another secondary man.
Now, what's the matter with Whatley? All of a sudden, he's not even getting off the field. Whatley sits down. We'll take a break. There's a timeout on the field. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
7 to go.
Yeah, well, it was a bigger play than the play before when you know you're going to catch the hitch for the first down.
Fassel gets the snap, and he kicks the ball. It's going to hit inside the 20 at the Aggies and bounces around 17-16 down to the 15. 27-yard return, no. Excuse me, 27-yard punt, no return. Aggies will take over on their own 15-yard line. Signals again, looks like he's autoing. Gonna give the ball to Mans. He's in left guard and he gets hit and lunges through. Jamie Daniels with a hand on him, can't bring him down. He's out to the 19-yard line, gain of 3, 2nd and 7.
Gives the ball, man. That's not man. This is backup Compton, I believe, and it goes out to the 29. Plenty good enough for a first down.
Mix up on the outside. No one had contain for the Tigers. Everybody's looking at each other, says, who's got outside contain? Nobody showed. Easy first down for New Mexico State.
And it's play after play. We talk about the offense for New Mexico State because that's all there is to talk about today. They've been on the field the entire day, and they've had it their way. Running, passing, everywhere you could hope. It's been offense for New Mexico State. They lead it right now 29-3.
Three wide receivers stay in the game for the Aggies. Ledbetter gives the ball. Compton wants to cut back. He's hit behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss. Bill Denny in on the tackle. 2:38 counting in the half. Loss of about a yard. It'll be 2nd and 11.
Tigers gonna let the clock go out.
Until you get down to third down, Kurt, I don't know if you want to do anything here.
Yeah, especially the way they're moving the football. You want to give them more time.
Sanchez into the sidelines, ball in the right hash. Davis in the slot. He's caught 2 touchdown passes already.
Draw. Steve Wright makes the tackle. No gain on the play. On the draw by Mans. 3rd and 10.
Well, you're 26 points behind. You want another shot.
I think so, too. Here.
And you would think there'd be a timeout call. Tigers are going to let the clock run. Which I don't quite understand. Because they get the ball in a pretty good field position because you know New Mexico State is happy to let this thing run out the way it is. Be surprised to see. Sanchez, a wide receiver, goes out with a pulled hamstring, his left hamstring.
He's a senior from Laney College.
Livermore, California.
Yeah, played over in Livermore Valley.
The Tigers have 2 timeouts left with 1:21 in a 3rd and 15 situation. Expect the draw because he's not going to try to get 15 yards back here. I'd be very surprised.
Well, he's got a 26-point lead. I just put the pedal to the metal, Kurt. Let's see. Offsides, and this time it's Jason Evans. So we'll go back to 3rd and 10 again.
Report on Watley is that he has had his bell rung. He's a little oozy on a play prior to the one that you saw, I guess, Kirk, because he didn't get hit on that play. But they are not sure if he'll return or not, so mild concussion, it appears.
Offsides against the Tigers.
So you go back to third and 10 again.
Yeah, Watley, when he got up after he as he started to walk off the field after he was in that sitting position for a full minute, he was still woozy.
You could tell he was dizzy. Boy, he gave the Tigers a great finish last week with a brilliant catch and run. Last play of the game to beat San Jose State. And it's a lesson in life. You go from the top to the bottom real quick.
In the fourth quarter, North Texas trails UNLV 27-17. Ledbetter sets up, plenty of time, going to be holding. He's going to run with the ball, 30, 35, 40, and out to the 45. Eludes one man and gets clear to midfield, 20 yards on the run. But there's a holding penalty back at the Aggie 27-yard line. And now we're down to 36 seconds to go in the half.
Heritage Cellular, the official cellular company of the Pacific Radio broadcasts, bringing you today's game. Also brought to you in part by the Bank of Stockton. Celebrating over 128 years of strength, safety, and stability. Bank of Stockton, member FDIC.
Here's a hold. 10-yard penalty to move it back from the spot of the foul. Take clear back to the Aggie 36-yard line.
Again, I would be real surprised if they try to throw the ball. You would.
Timeout, Pacific.
Pacific takes a timeout, and we will too. Tiger 47-yard line.
And that's why Pacific didn't want to take a timeout.
37 yards on the run and a bunch of poor tackling and a bunch of walking along the way. Now the Aggies take a timeout themselves. And want to keep it here, Robert?
No, let's break.
All right, we'll be right back. We'll be right back.
7. Slot formation to the wide side. Three wides. Ledbetter, plenty of time. He's going to run with the ball. Forced up the middle. 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, and all the way down to the 15-yard line. 32 yards on the run by Cody Ledbetter, and not much pursuit by the Blackshirts.
Sold out to try to get to him, then everybody else dropped in coverage. They had man coverage downfield, though, to account for the quarterback. That often is the case. Ledbetter took advantage of it.
11 seconds to go in the half. Aggies knocking on the door again. Remember, they had a third and 20, didn't they? Third and 22 at one point.
Yeah, it's not the most stimulating defense in the first half that Tigers displayed.
UNLV again leads North Texas 27-17 in the fourth quarter from Las Vegas. Oregon in the fourth for Washington, 28-21-10 in the fourth quarter. Northwestern, a team that believes they can win and would be undefeated had not Miami of Ohio of the MAC conference beat Northwestern the second set of Notre Dame. It's time, throws in the end zone. Stukes intercept. Aggies will have it. We'll break the score at the... loses at Nebraska 73-14, and here comes Coolin with the kickoff. It's a line drive, end over end in the corner. Reeder doesn't catch it, lets it hit. It bounces 1 yard inside the end zone and goes out of the side of the end zone. So Tigers will take over in their own 20.
Well, this is what you call the proverbial gut check.
Yeah.
I mean, you're going to find out what kind of character you've got. You don't know what coach had to say to the Tigers at halftime. It comes from within. No one's making tackles on defense. They're in position to make plays. Offensively, got to get going somewhere with either Abdullah or you commit yourself to the air and go to the outside.
Three wide receivers in the game, same way the Tigers started this game. New Mexico State shows blitz. They come late. Abdullah picks it up. It's Bowers with a little curl at the 29, and they'll mark it at the 30. Should be enough for a first down. So Graham Lee hits his first pass. He was 7 for 18 in the first half. I didn't give you that stat. 7 for 18 for 86 yards. Got sacked once and was fumbled once when he tried to get him out of trouble.
Well, again, Bob, I mean, you can run screens. You can run a lot of fancy stuff to go back to a little short side screen to Damon Bowers, who does a nice job catching it and moving the chains.
Ronnie Smith wide to the right. Bowers into the sidelines. Ryan Green is the tight end. Abdullah, left tackle, blocker in front of him, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, and into state territory at the 46-yard line, 24 yards for Joe A.
Two things could happen, Bob. Either the Tigers come out fired up or New Mexico State can come out flat. Right now, the Tigers are kind of getting back to their game plan. They're running a
Redbecker better from.
Ronnie Smith wide left. Atkins in the slot. Ball in the right hash. Second and five. It's going to be a blitz. Abdullah takes it outside. No, yes he does. 35 and inside the 32. Down to the 31 on the blitz. Nice play action fake by Graham Lee. I thought he kept the ball after all because Joe hesitated when he got the handoff. It'll be a first down for Pacific. And Abdullah over 30 yards already in the first half.
Ryan Green on the outside doing a great job sealing the corner so Joe could turn it and pick up the first down.
Kind of an unsung hero, Ryan Green, young man that missed a couple of ball games with back-to-back concussions, has a special attachment on his black Pacific helmet. Took it off at Fresno State, got hit in the side of the helmet. Graham Lee sets up, a lot of time. Curl, Bowers takes a hit, and it's all the way down to the 24-yard line. We'll call it a gain of about 7.5. It'll be second and short.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving Graham Lee time to go to the secondary receiver. That time, Damon Bowers. Damon kind of got caught between whether he wanted to catch it with his hands or his body. Did a little bit of both. But the important thing is he made the reception, and he's in second short position for his offense.
Bowers with three catches of this drive so far.
Ron Smith into the sidelines. Atkins in the slot. Bowers, last time he caught a ball here at Louisiana Tech, was a touchdown. Ramley sets up, looking over the middle. Nice catch by Ryan Green about the 19-yard line. Another first down. Ramley looks like he's dropping his elbow slightly all day. Those balls are a little high. They've all been caught on this drive, but sailed the ball a little bit there in the first half. Kurt.
Well, yeah, you're a technician. I mean, this is something you made a living at, but he also might be a little bit eager wanting to get the ball there as soon as possible.
Lee, yep. 4-4 on this drive, throwing the football.
Young man with a lot of natural ability. Bowers into the sidelines. Ryan Green tight to the left side. Option into the sidelines. Graham keeps it, turns inside. He's inside the 9. Nice running, and it's very close to another first down. A good decision, as you like to say, Kurt Heinrich.
Yeah, it was, and it was also a heck of a block by Dan Weldon. You don't often see a guy 6'5", 302, load block. When I mean by load block, he's out in front of it, chopping the feet from the defender, and he's the guy that paved the way for Graham Lee.
9.5 on the game, the ball on the 9.5, so it's second and short. Motion by Bowers across the formation. Let's see if Abdullah goes back to the tight end side. No, he doesn't. Graham Lee rolls out, looking. Takes a long time. It looked like Ronnie Smith was bumped in the back of the end zone. Tigers take a shot at it. I think that's a good call. I like it. It's third and short. Now you give the ball to Abdullah, let him get the first down.
Well, there's nothing wrong with trying to score. You obviously need touchdowns desperately. Clearly the Tigers can get, they're going to go for it twice, so you're right. You pound it away with either Blakeney or Abdullah. And with Blakeney not in there, you go with Abdullah.
Let's see if they just play the run the whole way. Bowers, motion. See if they come to the tight end side.
Quarterback snake, first down. Boy, he got hit.
Humble, too.
Yeah, but I think he was hit, and it gave him the forward positioning. A lot of pushing and shoving down there.
I think Graham thought he was just going to lean forward and get it, and he got
punished. Got it. He leaned forward, and he did get it.
It opened up for him.
He put his nose in the can he didn't want to get
into. Well, let's see where they mark this football now. They're going to measure it.
He's got it. He's got it by the stripe to the nose of the football. How's that?
Which stripe?
The front stripe to the nose of the football.
That close.
Yeah.
That is some nice vision, Bob.
Thank you. New bifocals.
New bifocals. We'll see you there. You're that old now, huh?
No, I just have bad eyes.
Oh. That's what Tom Stubbs used to say when he'd watch you walk back from the batter's box. And he doesn't have it. 2 inches short. You're 4 inches off, Caresco. From 100 yards away. Not 100, but about 70. Got to go for it here. Come on, guys.
Well, I'll tell you,
get it on his first surge, and then a penalty flag popped into the air, and we'll see what this call is. Tigers running the first 3 minutes and 15 seconds off this third quarter clock, moving the ball niftily downfield, trying to get a score to start things off. It's going to be against New Mexico State.
Pinching in there tight, trying to take away the alley, figuring the quarterback's going to sneak it on in there. If they did it on third down, you got to believe they're going to come back with it. Tigers have opportunities in the secondary, Bob. They've got Atkins in the slot. Man, I'm telling you, he is not going to be covered, and he won't be covered for the rest of the game. They have to work the ball to him.
Well, I think you got to give your big back the ball down here.
First things first, Tigers need to score in the worst way, a six-pointer at least, and then they got to go to work on defense.
How about your option right here again? Dollar's not going to go in motion this time. Graham Lee, Joe Abdullah wants to go out left tackle. He's going to score. Touchdown! First to go from the 4.5-yard line. Abdullah! 11:22 to go. Tigers on the board with their first TD. They trail 29-9. McSweeney will try the PAT.
Mexico State will take Grambley running the option all afternoon long.
Absolutely.
Well, he got 9.5 last time he carried before that one. So 7.5, we'll call it. Ball on the 22.5. Weston in motion across the formation. Grambley sets up. Time. Lots of time. Rolls out. Abdullah, one-handed catch at the 15, inside the 10, and down to the 9. What a catch by Joe Abdullah. The ball behind him. He reached back, caught it, and got back in stride and broke to the boundary. First to goal, Tigers.
That was a nice job by Graham Lee, having the patience to wait for Joe to open up, coming clear across the formation. He wanted his tight end, Ryan Green, then found Abdullah, and like you said, Abdullah with a one-handed catch. Thought he probably could have gone with two hands, but what the heck, he made it.
Tight end to the left, two wide receivers to the left, Atkins and Weston. Graham Lee sets up, looking. Touchdown, Greg Weston! What a nice catch up in the air. Tigers 15, Aggies 29.
Is it my imagination or did Weston elevate?
Oh, he got way up.
Oh, man. He's got some leaps now, let me tell you.
Yeah, they had to wait for him to come down before they hit him, and he had full possession when he came down. Tigers back-to-back scores in this second half. Tigers going to go for two here. Why would they do that now? Think about this. Two gives them 17. You still got to get 13 more to win.
Here we go.
Tigers come out. Three wides in the game. Abdullah stays in at the ace back spot. Motion. Here's your option. What do you think? Nope. Roll out. Graham Lee, lots of times. Going to run it. Gets hit. And he got the ball across the plate.
No.
They say no. They say his knee was down first. What a great effort by Graham Lee. Nobody likes that call. We're too far away to say one way or another from here.
I'd have to guess that his knee touched before he reached forward to get the ball across, and that would be the case.
He took a big hit, too. He looked
This time Mans moves from his left to his right. Tigers show blitz, fake it, come off. They're covering it the whole way. And Lucius Davis falls down, just lunges up enough to catch the low line drive from Ledbetter. It's going to be third and short.
Boy, that is a supreme effort there to make that catch.
He was
brilliant. Catch.
They're going to measure it. We'll keep it right here. Again, Ty Watley out with a concussion.
Fine throw, too, to put it down.
Yeah.
He knows his receiver had hit the ground, and he puts it about a half a foot off the ground, right on the button.
Well, the Tigers coming out here in the second half, trailing 29-3, have put two scores on the board, both for only 6 points, as they missed the PAT in the first attempt and then tried to go for two on the second, came up a half yard short, and now trail 29-15, but a good sign for the Tigers. But they've got to hold. They can't get into an exchange of scores here in this position of the game.
I agree with you, and they've got to come up with something right here. It's going to be about the same distance as it was for the Tigers before.
Yeah, I'd almost rather they had the first down here. Gives them an extra down to work with. It's less than 2 inches for the first down right now.
Yes,
Tigers at
third
home
and 2 inches.
Again, next weekend against Nevada Reno. They can set the table with a huge comeback here this afternoon in their quest for a Big West championship, but they got to get by these Aggies right now, and they have come quite a ways here in the second half, but still trail 29-15.
So third and short, if you're New Mexico State, do you just try to get the first down and then come back and start throwing again? I think you do.
Oh, yeah.
Ledbetter on the sneak.
Mm-hmm.
Or man, so it's a sneak. He got it at right guard. First down, Aggies. He gains about a yard just outside the Tiger 38-yard line.
Yes, and now for a first down.
Guinness comes back in for Donnie Spriggan.
It's again where you have to put pressure on Cody Ledbetter, because when he gets time, obviously he's going to kill you, but if you put pressure on him, he's going to throw some balls up where he shouldn't.
Totally still afternoon at Stagg Stadium in Stockton, California. Beautiful afternoon for doing a lot of things. Ledbetter, play action fake. Got Katoz Zerwanka, almost brought him down. Now Ledbetter's going to run, crosses the 35 to the 30, beats Denny, 25, 20, and is run out of bounds by Burton at the 18-yard line. 20 yards on the carry for Ledbetter. Ledbetter in the first half had 34 yards, gained 31 net. He's up to 51 yards now.
Yeah, he's doing it all. I mean, he's getting himself out of trouble with his feet.
Kato Zawanga blitzed, had him by the heel, couldn't bring him down, and Ledbetter was off to the races and beat Denny to the corner. Tiger defense given too many yards, too many minutes again here. First and 10, Aggies. Ball on the left hash at the Tiger 18-yard line. 29-15, Aggies lead. Tigers have scored twice here in the third quarter. Tigers show blitz. Ledbetter audibles blitz. Gets away. Time. Zawanka. Elliot Burke misses him. Had him wrapped up. Ledbetter's going to run with it. He dives to the ground at the 16. He'll gain two. And Burke should have made the play. Had him dead to rights. I've seen Elliot do that about four times this year. He comes right over the back of the guy's head. Misses.
Coming up high, goes in the middle. Then the middle never moves. You can always duck the head. Quarterbacks have an instinct ability to know when guys are going to be around them to duck their head. Self-preservation.
It's an instinct and it's an innate ability. How about that? Huh?
Yeah, well.
But you're right. You can feel it. The good guys can feel that. They don't fear it. They feel it. Right, Kurt?
His
dad was one of those guys.
Yeah.
Could feel the rush, feel the pressure, know when to move, even though you don't see it. Man slides up, blitz, Ledbetter throws the ball. It's deflected at the line of scrimmage. Sean Duncan. Second, it'd be now third and eight at the 16. Duncan with another nice play. A young man from Modesto JC, Calaveras High School.
Yeah, he's a guy that's knocked down a few balls so far this year. He's got that big wingspan, if you will.
6'4", 247-pounder. Hurt a knee in the Fresno State game. Ty Locatelli was lost probably for the year with a broken arm in that game. So
was a close one.
Well, it makes a big difference. They're going to call it on the Tigers. Chuck Shelton is upset about that. He's on the sidelines at the 25-yard line.
Yeah,
you can't give up five easy yards on a third and eight.
No, because now you give an opportunity for Mann to pick up the first down.
That's right.
And he's a guy so far in the game who once he's hit, he doesn't go backwards. He manages to squirt forward. And that's the difference between getting the first down and not getting the first down.
Tigers show blitz again. Let's see if they're going to come or not. Ledbetter audibles. Wants to throw the post. Yeah, he does. He's going to move to his right. Holding against the Aggies. Ledbetter's going to throw it in the end zone. And it's incomplete. Now, do you take the penalty or you make him go for it on fourth down? I'd make him kick the field goal, wouldn't you?
Let's
see. Back him up.
I'll see how far.
15.
Where they call it.
10 from the point, you got to take the penalty. Point of the foul is the 16-yard line. To move it back outside the 25, you take the flag.
Yeah, I'd move back.
And they are, because Burke's coming in.
I'd absolutely move back.
10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Moves the ball to the 25-yard line.
And now you get another good rush. You take him out of field goal range. Yeah, if they held him here and there was no gain, it would be a 42-yarder.
Wouldn't be surprised to see him come back with the draw here. It's been a good play for him this game.
Denny moves up close to the line. I don't know if they're going to go get there. Backing off. They fake the blitz. He wants it all inside. Double coverage. Davis can't get there. Burton with a nice job faking the blitz and running back in the seam. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, they played a game with Cody and they won. They gave the allure of a blitz from everybody, brought the safeties up, and then peeled off.
Bad. Burton couldn't see that ball because that's an INT if he sees it. Nigel with a nice job faking the blitz on the weak side, then running back into the seam.
Up to Bubba Coolin now. He'll try a 42-yarder from here.
I like that. We should Bubba Carrasco. There should have been a Bubba Carrasco around there.
But as a kicker, he's got to be a linebacker, O-line.
He's a big guy. This will be a 42-yarder, low snap. Coolin hits it, and it's right down the middle. It's good. It was a lazy end-over-end kick, but it made it 32-15. Aggies over the Tigers. 5:16 to go in the third quarter. We'll be back.
Stukes was the guy to protect him. He didn't do a very good job. That was best speed on the team. At some point, you'd like to see him in there where he could do something with that speed on the outside.
Thompson, the freshman cornerback, far to the left on the right side of the Tiger offense. Ronnie Smith against him. Looks like mano mano. Bowers in motion across the formation. Screen underneath. Abdullah blockers. 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 40. Hit from behind. The Aggies come up with the ball on their own 2-yard line. Abdullah hit at the 9-yard line. Gets 63 yards on the play.
Yep, you're exactly
right.
What
a great call and a great run by Joe Abdullah.
You don't see Joe give it up very often. He didn't see the defender. The defender slipped in behind. The ball wasn't really tucked away. He was trying to get to the goal line desperately and was stripped of the football.
What a great call, great run, wonderful blocking. He gets hit from the backside, loses the ball. Ronnie Smith was in front of him, but blocking and had his back to the ball, doing a nice job. If Abdullah breaks the last tackle, he scores standing up. Instead, the Aggies take over on their own 2-yard line. So it's up to the defense to hold them down here. 4:49 to go in the third quarter. Lots of time to play. Tigers show blitz again. They get Mintz. It's a safety.
Wow,
it's a safety.
They drop both corners, and they sandwiched on them. Safety. Tigers get two. Great defensive call.
And great job, guys. To hang in there. We'll keep it right here. McGinnis unofficially getting credit for the safety, although I think Vince Bruno and Wasworth Zawanga right there, and you heard Kurt say, both cornerbacks came in and blitzed and crashed the corner. Or was that Carrasco?
It was Bob.
You're kidding. He didn't know. He knows baseball. He'd have known if it was a split finger, but he didn't know about corners crashing.
Yeah, but you know one thing. You know the Tigers are gambling now. They're coming with everything, and right there, they get that 2 points back and possession, so they're cooking with gas now.
Would have been nice to have that touchdown. What a great play by Joe Abdullah. Good blocking by Chu and Weldon and John Z on the screen. A nice fake by Graham Lee.
But Bob, you've developed confidence now. The offense is moving the ball at will, and they know it. And you know why they know it? Just look at the offensive line. They're out in front. They're moving around. That's how you judge an offense. The offensive line has a snap in their stride. You know things are going well.
32-17, 4:45 to go in the third quarter. Zeka will punt for the first time today.
Tigers trail by 15 now. Keep the point spread in mind.
Beautiful punt.
Wow.
Atkins is going to go all the way back, field it at the 16. He's up to the 20, 25, 30. Breaks a tackle, 35, and out to the 36-yard line. Eric Atkins, 20 yards on the return.
That was a
heck of a punt, wasn't it?
Huge punt.
Look, he hit it 64 yards, 65 yards. When he hit it on the 19, went all the way to the 16. 65 yards in the air.
Boy, Eric Atkins has some excitement when he gets his hands on the football, doesn't
man.
He?
Got to find a way to get him the ball more. Huh?
He can move.
Little tiny guy. 32-17, 4:37 to go, third quarter. Tigers, had they played like this at the beginning, this game would be over in the other direction. Bowers, motion across the formation. He gets the ball, 40, out to the 42-yard line, a gain of 6.
Unofficially, Bowers' fourth catch of the second half alone.
And, you know, I've been calling it all day, this Jeffrey Thompson. He's the guy you got to work over. He's a true freshman at quarterback. There's no way he's going to make plays. It's that simple.
God, I love it when you take complex formulas and make them simple.
Well, some of the greatest things in life are.
Ronnie Smith, wide right. Atkins in the slot. Bowers to the sideline. Ryan Green, the tight end. Graham Lee sets up underneath. Bowers, first down. Aggies, 49-yard line.
Bowers' fifth catch of the second half.
There's been so much mention of this West Coast offense and a lot of people, motion offense and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And the more you can eliminate things and simplify, the better off you'll probably be.
season, both playing very well. Option, sidelines. Graham Lee keeps it, slides inside, and is hit from behind. Luckily, holds onto the ball, and he's down to the 43-yard line. It'll be second and four, gain of six.
I saw a fumble all over that when he got hit from the backside. Real loose handle on the football.
Ball on the left hash, second and four. Aggie 43-yard line, Tigers on a sustained drive again.
Got to work that big number 33.
Boy, another score here is going to be huge. Nice.
Lee Cole signals Aggies backing off deep, looking for the pass. Ryan Green, should be pass interference. Oh, no way. Oh, my goodness.
Boy, everybody in the stadium saw it, but the official.
Joby Lewis, and that would have been a first down, too. It was inside the 38. It was interference would have made it a penalty first down. Terrible call. Boy, is Chuck upset about that. And he should be. Walks over to talk to the side judge, Bob Sanso.
Third down and four for the Tigers.
You can battle the 11 on the field. It's tough to battle those other five and six in striped shirts. Motion by Bowers across the formation. Graham Lee rolls right. Abdullah blocking in front of him. Throws the screen back to Ryan Green. Doesn't know where to go. He finds room. Crosses the 40 and down to the 38. They say he's down.
He had the first down on a great effort, and then before he went down, they said the ball popped loose. There was Eric Atkins to fall on it. The Tigers pick up another 7 yards on the fumble forward.
You know, I tell you what, as many substitutions as New Mexico State is coming with, it might be interesting to see the Tigers go their no huddle.
First down for Pacific on the Aggie just inside the 32-yard line, Bob. Didn't you think he was down there?
I thought he was down, yeah. Before he fumbled. Yes,
great
I did.
Great play by Eric Atkins. That's the play of this drive so far, getting on that loose ball. Bowers into the sidelines, Atkins in the slot. He's in motion now. Bowers across the formation. Quick set. Bowers flat, 25, runs almost through the tackle. Gain of 8.5 inside the Aggie 24.
And look who they're working. They're working the freshman. And he's looking at the sidelines to the coaches like, I was in position. But they flooded my zone. Which guy should I pick?
Well, they tried to give him help.
Well, yeah, but you're not going to get the help because you're coming from inside out and they can't make the play.
Bowers with his sixth catch here in the second half.
Graham Lee sets up, looks over the defense. Atkins in the slot on the left hash. Ball on the right hash. Second and a short two. They're going to blitz here. Abdullah slides it outside. 20, 15, 10, 5. And he's jerked out of bounds at the 1 yard line. Joe Abdullah, 23 yards on the gain. You can see that blitz coming. Joe saw it, ran with his eyes, and took it outside.
And I don't mean to do this. I really don't, but they keep going at the same cornerback wherever he is.
Oh, shut up.
The Tigers find him.
I'll tell you that, Abdullah.
He had forced corner, and Abdullah went right through him.
Great run by Joe Abdullah.
I mean, it's a fact. And the coaches have identified a mismatch, and they're taking advantage of it.
Here come the Tigers, line of scrimmage. They trail 32-17, minute 44 to go in the third quarter. Lee sets his line.
And Lee up here calls it. Blakeney in the backfield. Give it to one of your big guys. Let them earn it. Mistake. Graham Lee rolls outside, gets tripped up, and loses 9 yards. 1:38 to go in the third quarter. I think he missed the handoff, Bob.
Yeah, he did. He missed the handoff to Blakeney into the line, and then he was struggling for his life, and he got tripped up and trying to keep his balance. He kept running away from the goal line, lost 9.
Jeez. Terrible. Terrible mistake. Abdullah with 83 yards receiving, 108 yards receiving, 83 yards rushing. Tigers with a second and goal now at the 10. Boy, can't do that. A monumental mistake. Let's see if they can overcome it. Weston in motion. Graham Lee rushes on him. Screen. Abdullah, 5-4. Lunges. He got it. Joe Abdullah, what a play. Oh. Now, why would Ronnie Smith come over and push him that much, though? I hate when guys get excited. Pushed him all the way out of bounds.
I'll tell you what, that was a tremendous effort. Abdullah looked like he was going to be pinned in and knocked down at the 5-yard line. Instead, he ran through a tackle and then left his feet at the 4 and drove all the way for the pylon in the corner of the front of the end zone and got it.
picked up.
Tigers put
safety.
The ball on the left hash. They're allowed to dictate where they want the ball set. Grambley sets up. He's got him. Tries to throw the ball in the middle. He had the man in the flat, but we've got a penalty flag down. Let's see what's going on here.
May have been an offensive lineman downfield.
Thompson said it's on the Tigers. Let's see if it is. Procedure on the Tigers. Aggies will refuse. We'll break in the action. Tigers 23, Aggies 32.
Took 4 minutes off the clock. The scoreboard now reads Pacific 23, New Mexico State 32.
Sweeney gets a kind of a bobbler that's picked up at the 28-yard line and a nice tackle. That's number 46 on Johansson, the backup linebacker, fields that ball, returns it about 5 or 6 yards. Aggies will take over, and for a squib kick, it's got to be farther than that, doesn't it, Kurt?
Yeah, and Burton makes the tackle. Well, here you go. The defense, they've done a great job here in the second half.
Where they marked it. Maybe I called it there. I thought he was out to the 34. We'll take it. Just short of the 33. 53 seconds to go. Third quarter. Aggies have been outscored by the Tigers 20-3 in this last 14 minutes. Ledbetter again calls signals at the line. He's changing the play right here, Kurt. You can see him doing it. Sets up. Backside blitz. Wants to throw. Davis takes a big hit, but he gains about 9 and gets a great mark. It's still going to be short of a first down, I would think.
Have a Tiger on the field not getting up.
Where's that?
The corner on that side, Chris Pond, reviewing him right now.
Oh, I can't. Yeah, there, everybody's standing in front of him. Is that McGinnis? Was he involved in the hit there?
Yeah, I believe it was Stukes, perhaps.
Let's see.
Well, why they stay 10 to them. Let's recap the scoring here in the second half. Tigers came out with the first score of the second half, an 80-yard, 10-play drive. Abdullah went the final 4, PAT no good. Then Pacific got their hands on the football again with 10 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the quarter. And they moved it 25 yards after a fumble recovery on 3 plays, a minute off the clock. Weston from Lee for an 8-yard catch. Then New Mexico State came back, and Bubba Coolin hit a 42-yard field goal. But the Tigers coming back and making the score 32-15 on a, 32-17 on a safety. Then Pacific got their hands on the football after the ensuing punt back, after the safety, and the Tigers into the end zone. This time Abdullah, 23-32, the Tigers trail. The Tigers went for 2 and missed again. Have they made an extra point today?
They made the first one on the knuckleball.
That's right, only 1 extra point.
Rodney Campbell into the game. He was a star a year ago, picked off an interception and ran it in for a touchdown to give the Tigers their first winning season in 17 years.
Tigers down by 9, 32-23. 42 seconds still remaining here in the third quarter. Remember, it was 29-3 at halftime.
Abdullah, as you said, with great efforts there and great efforts by the offensive line, too. You can't do it alone at this level of college football. So we got second and short for the Aggies. It might be a waste down here if they, you've got 2 tight ends in the game. See what they do. They're going to give the ball to Mans. He's hit for a loss. Jamie Daniels, a loss of 2 back to just outside the Aggie 40-yard line. Should probably be the last play of the third quarter, and it will be. So we'll break in the action at the end of 3. Aggies 32, Tigers storming back at 23.
goes back in for Spragan. Campbell was injured against Louisiana Tech. Burton gonna blitz into the runner. Ledbetter tries to roll outside. Conrad's got him. He throws the ball way away. Let's see what we got here.
Penalty flag on the toss.
Nice play by Conrad. Great blitzing by Burton.
Boy, the Tigers have really flip-flopped here in the second half, though. Their defense has come to life, and they have New Mexico State running for their lives.
Well, I think the defensive coaching staff stressed a couple things. One, tackle the ball carrier. Two, contain.
Ineligible receiver downfield.
Yeah, lineman snuck down, or they covered up the tight end. The tight end went out in the pass pattern is what happened. But the Tigers' defensive coaching staff has made some tremendous adjustments at halftime. They've contained the quarterback and gave him pressure up the middle, thus eliminating his throwing lanes.
Chuck Shelton wants him to take the penalty. Denny looking for the signal from the sidelines, gets it. It'll be first and 20. First and 15. Why is it only a 5-yard penalty? Let's see here.
I guess because that's the rule?
Well, yeah, but I thought if it was a 5-yarder, it'd be loss of down. Guess not. I'm wrong. I think Chuck thought it was more, too, or he wouldn't have taken it, I don't think. Tiger's going to set up show blitz. Here comes Burton late, trying to get there. He can't. Ledbetter complete over the middle at the 40 to Davis. Campbell misses the hit. And Waswa Zawanga makes a hit. First down, gain of about 20 on the play. We've got our third quarter statistics, and boy, there's been a change there. 19 for 33 for Graham Lee, 242 yards. Abdullah, 87 yards rushing instead of the 23 he had in the first half. Ledbetter now 18 for 31. With that completion, he's 19 for 32. Davis with his seventh catch just then. Takes him almost to 100 yards. He's in the 90s. Draw, Mans, he breaks through the middle, and he's nearly down to the 32-yard line, maybe the 31, and be very close to another first down.
Yeah, boy, that's tough. The Tigers had New Mexico State on the ropes offensively here. They didn't have the continuity nor the tempo that they had liked in the first half. You get an offside penalty that has changed the tide in this particular drive.
Mans had five carries for 18 yards in that quarter after racking up 162 yards in the first half. Second and a yard and a half just outside the Tiger 31-yard line. Ledbetter again audibles. Blitz. Burton coming late. They've got Davis. Single coverage out there at the 21-yard line on the blitz, and it's a first down. They got to get there sooner.
Well, or you got
to the quarterback.
Up. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. No. The cornerback can't do too much else there. I mean, he's got to give him a little bit room. Ledbetter had plenty of time to throw there.
Well, as an old receiver, the toughest thing to do is evade the bump and run. You can run 10 yards and not be impeded.
Right.
It's real easy to run your routes. If you got a guy covering you, then you got more things to think about, and you're making the cornerback throw to a spot that's tough to do.
Davis with his ninth catch of the ball game. Tiger's going to blitz. Ledbetter sees it, wants to get rid of it. Going to roll outside. He's got running room. 20, 15, 10, and slides down at the 5-yard line. First down, Aggies.
Well, when you sell out and to get to the quarterback and you don't get to him, it leaves nobody in the linebacker area to pick up the quarterback. Thus, if the quarterback can squirt through there, he's going to have a lot of real estate in front of him. And that's what we're seeing with Cody Ledbetter. He's done a good job staying alive amongst fierce pressure by the Tiger defense.
Sean Duncan was signaling for the longest time he wanted out of the ball game, and finally the sideline recognized it and sent somebody in for him.
Cut his hand, I think.
Yeah.
He's looking at his right hand. Needs to get it retaped. Man's going to slide outside, and he doesn't get to the goal line, but he makes a great effort to get to the one. McGinnis in on the hit, along with Denny, who tried to get him, and Bruno, who did. Second and goal at the one.
Tiger defense needed to stiff it. That offsides penalty, as you said, Kurt, really made a difference.
Yep, because they had held him. And now Cody Ledbetter is getting the tempo going in his offensive team's way. And he's done it by himself.
Going to give the ball to Mason.
The official signal.
38-23. Tigers trail by 15. The snap is good. The kick is up. Some help now. We're going to play double coverage here, Kurt. You can see the safety's backing way off. Graham, I hope he sees it go back over the middle. No, he overthrows Morales. He had the right guy, and he just couldn't pull the trigger.
Yeah.
Boy, it would have been running room, too, at the 30-yard line.
It opened
second
up.
Second and 10.
Yeah, you're right, Bob. It opened up nicely. They cleared out the top of the two receivers. The slot receiver on the outside with Atkins opened up for the tight end. He just missed him a little bit.
Three wide receivers in the game, second and 10, ball on the right hash. Abdullah, draw, not gonna get anywhere, no place. They're looking for that the whole way. So now, with great field position, there's no gain, it'll be third and 10. No, Bobby can't come out and play right now, the phone rings. 10:56 to go in the ball game. Tigers trail 39-23. They started a valiant comeback in the third quarter, outscoring the Aggies 20-3. Graham Lee calls signal. Weston in motion across the formation. They want to throw the screen, nowhere to go. He throws it down. Abdullah makes the catch, 40, 35, and down inside the 31-yard line. What a great catch and run by Joe Abdullah, and good back blocks by Brian Chu and Mike Morales and Almaz Jangi.
And what a throw, too. I mean, he put that between two defenders, unless I saw something different. That was a finely tuned throw by Graham Lee. And who did the Tigers go to when they got to every single time?
Big Joey.
Number, big number 33.
Weston into the sidelines. Morales stays. once again, Kurt Heinrich.
And with each crack, and they move the chains,
the clock stops.
The clock stops. So tempo is kind of a critical thing here, and the Tigers do have the tempo.
Yes, they do. They're going to place that ball just inside the 17-yard line. This time, Atkins in the slot to the right. Hofer comes over to the right sideline also. Double coverage by the Aggies. Abdullah inside the 15, down to about the 13, maybe even the 12. It'll be a gain of 4, maybe 5 yards. Call it a gain of 4.5, second and 5.5.
This will be an interesting call here. Why don't the Tigers come back to the screen? It's been effective here towards the end zone area.
That was a great play last time by Abdullah and Graham Lee.
Yeah, a little weak side screen away from the tight end.
I like when they brought the guy in motion and threw in the flat to him. They had it on the 2.2. Graham Lee doing a nice job. Abdullah wants to take it outside left tackle. Nowhere to go, and he gets down to the 10 anyway. And if you're the Tigers, you know you're in four down territory here.
Clearly.
Let's see what they got, Kurt. It's going to be 2.5, nearly.
I think there also needs to be a little sense of urgency with the Tigers getting in and out of their huddle here. With
yeah.
As they get under 9 minutes here.
You're right, Kurt. Tiger Pep Band doing an outstanding job. All the kids from our music conservatory under Eric Hammer's direction. Abdullah at the line of scrimmage. Looks like he got the first down inside the 8. See where they marked this. Looks like nearly the 6. Good, hard running. A nice surge by that offensive line. Pacific, keep it going now.
Yeah, I don't think New Mexico State truly minds this if the clock is going to continue to run.
Chuck Shelton yells just what you did to the, from the sidelines. Get it going. Tigers come out. Holford in the slot. Look for Atkins to come back in motion towards the formation, and he does. Atkins is the guy they want. Looking. Graham Lee's going to run with it. He's almost to the goal line. He's down inside the 1. A nice run. Good athleticism once again. Ryan Green will come in for a 2 tight end set. We've got 8:04 and counting.
Well, and it was also a very heady play in trying to make something happen that's not there. He could have very easily tried to force it to Eric Atkins, who was breaking free late, but decided to go straight upfield.
He didn't get much of a mark, but he's right at the 1-yard line. The weak side tight end. Blakeney in at the true fullback spot. Weston stays in at the wing back. Blakeney, he jumps up. He didn't cross the plane. He gained almost the entire yard, so it'll be 3rd and goal, about the 1-foot line, I would imagine. If you knock Kerry Blakeney back, you're delivering a blow.
Yeah, and you've got penetration.
It's about a foot off
two-point conversion that makes it an eight-point football game.
And then what do? You kick to him or you go for an onside kick?
Kick to 7 minutes, you kick to him, and then you're going to need two scores no matter what because the tie is not going to do you much good.
Tigers come out, ball half the distance to the goal line, motion. Weston across the formation. Abdullah is going to score the two. All right, we'll break in the action. The score, Tigers 31, Aggies up by eight. They've got 39. We'll be right back. Tigers scoring once again. This was a 42-yard, nine-play drive, but it took 4 minutes and 20 seconds off the clock, capped off by a one-yard plunge by the burly fullback, Kerry Blakeney. Abdullah with some nice runs sprinkled in. The Tigers now trail by eight, but there's 7:02 to go in the game. Tigers going to need two scores to get a win. Here we go.
They needed two last week, and they got it. This time, the ball's hit end over end, and it's fielded and caught at the 16-yard line.
Holy smokes, that was a blunder. We'll take it. Jamon Johnson, sophomore linebacker, signals fair catch. Look at the mark he gets. He kneeled on the 16-yard line. He caught the ball over his head.
Well, typically, you'll see that if it's more popped up in the air. That one, I don't think, had the height that the special teams coach would have wanted his up back to call for the fair catch, but nonetheless, he signaled for it.
We're in for a well of a finish here. The Tigers can stiffen on defense. Let's see.
Ledbetter's been the difference.
They're playing single coverage right now on Davis.
That jump on the left tackle, Bob, I think jumped out of position for New Mexico State.
That's number 73, and he's not even on my
76.
Original. Is it 76?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Greg Snyder. He was originally the right tackle, and they moved him to left.
All of the New Mexico State offensive linemen had their shirt off. When they stand together, it looks like a curtain. None of their shirts are tucked in.
That's a great observation here. 7 minutes to go in the game, 39-31. Tigers down by eight. Here comes the Aggies' line of scrimmage.
That's why he gets a big cash here. Spot those type of tendencies. The Tigers show blitz here. Let's see if they back off. They do. They're going to try to get to Ledbetter with a four-man rush. Ledbetter wants it all, and Davis pushed off of Burke.
Yeah.
And it wasn't called, but the ball is way past him anyway. It'll be second and 15. That could have easily been offensive interference.
This is the point of the game where when you've been pass protecting a lot and you can tell that the New Mexico State offensive line is tired, that you're going to get some holding calls because the Tigers are getting through and the New Mexico State offensive line is starting to reach. And when the arms get outside away from the body, you're going to see the flag.
All right, here we go.
Second down to 15.
Second and 15. David is isolated over here again on McGinnis, isn't he? He wants to come this way. Throws it incomplete into the ground at the 18-yard line, and we dodge a bullet there, huh?
Well, we dodge a bullet, or we miss a bullet, because McGinnis had a pickoff into the end zone, but he couldn't come up with the football.
He just missed it. He just missed it. Oh, man. Lucius Davis got enough of his right arm in there to distract.
And the reason there wasn't a call is that Davis was doing an up push into the defender, then busting off him, and he just got hooked up with it.
Well, that's twice, so he's pushed off. Third and 10 now.
Here we go, baby.
6:48 to go in the ball game.
Strap it up.
We've seen 70 points scored this afternoon so far. Burke wants to rush him inside. There's a hole. Here comes Duncan. Ledbetter is going to throw it up for Graham. sort that out. Abdullah, 18 rushes, 106 yards, 7 receptions, 131 yards. First time in his career he's equaled 100 yards in both categories. Graham Lee, 20 of 35, throwing the football, 255 yards. Penalty on New Mexico State.
When this is all over, I'm going to show you guys a fortune cookie that I opened yesterday.
Can't wait.
Wednesday, actually. I told Chuck about it.
Is that right?
Thursday, I opened. These weeks go by so fast during the fall that
the Aggies will have to punt it away after that call. It's fourth down and 15 yards to go. And back deep to return, Kurt Heinrich pointing to him, Eric Atkins. He is a spark plug, can go from anywhere.
Zeka, who punted the ball 65 yards on the free kick after the safety last time, standing in his own end zone to receive the snap. The snap is low. Zeka gets it away, barely. What a great punt. And it's fielded Atkins, 37, 40, 45, and out of bounds, about the 49-yard line. Eric Atkins with 13 yards on the punt return, and a great punt by Chad Zeka.
Under the pressure of Nigel Burton, who almost took it off his foot.
Was it Burton or was it Missouri?
It was Burton.
Gee.
He almost blocked it.
I thought he had it, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. It went under him is what happened. He didn't go to the foot. He went to the punter.
Here we go, Tigers. 6:26 to go. Nose of the football just inside the 50-yard line on Tiger's side of the ball. Three wide receivers. Ronnie Smith's been quiet this afternoon so far. Fine receiver out of Skyline, Oakland. Graham Lee in trouble. Buys time. Lots of time. He's going to run with the football. 50, 45, and down inside Aggie territory. About the 43-yard line.
One of the Tigers extremely upset getting hit late on the play, but the rest of his
Jefferson,
teammates,
yeah.
They bring him back. Great play by Lee to scramble out of trouble, changing directions twice, then weaving his way upfield for an 8-yard pickup.
Atkins, huh? Atkins running down the middle of the field at the 25-yard line when Graham Lee made that great scramble. I know there's so many things to think about. This young man is playing so well, it's hard to see everything at such a young age. Boy, if he'd have found Atkins there, they're going for two then. Abdullah, right side, got blocking, stumbles, but he gets the first down, crosses the 40. And we got almost a fight going down here with Bowers. Bowers and Manuel.
Tigers need to keep their poise.
Let me reiterate Graham Lee on the afternoon, 20 of 35 after a dismal first half, 255 yards, just doing a great job. Redshirt freshman took him away from defeat into victory last week, trying to do it again this evening. Here we go.
He said he's 20 for 35. He was 7 for 18 in the first half, so he's 13 for 17 in the second half. First and 10, ball at the right hash, just inside the Aggie 40-yard line. Graham Lee sets up once again, looking, over the middle. And the Aggies dodge a bullet. Ryan Green gets a hand on it. It sure looked like Joe B. Lewis, or was that Thompson, Jeffrey Thompson, with a hand on Green.
I don't
It'll
know if his hand's
ten.
Tied up, Bob, or if he's just putting one hand out for the ball. Looks like he's wrapped up. I don't know what it is.
It looks different.
Awfully
it?
Awkward going after the football, though.
Tentative, I think, is the way he's approaching the football.
Might be right.
Well, I don't. I won't even say that.
I just haven't watched him close enough, but it looks like he's always got one paw going out for it, and he's wrapped up with the other.
Bowers into the sidelines. Atkins going to come in motion across the formation. Graham Lee sets up, wants to throw the screen underneath, changes his mind. Lots of time. Got to get rid of it, Graham. And he throws the ball intended for Abdullah. And look, no, there's nobody down. Look at where our offensive linemen are. There's not one guy across that line of scrimmage.
What Bob is yelling about is that the official threw the flag after the play was over.
That's
we looked downfield to see if there were any linemen downfield. Did not see any unless one snuck down and then went back. That's what
terrible.
The call is. Kurt, did you see any offensive linemen breakdown?
Not one.
No, I didn't.
Taffa Jefferson was on the line of scrimmage and never went downfield. And if you're making a block, the rule is if you maintain your contact, you could beat 5 yards down the field, and it's not an ineligible receiver downfield. That's a terrible call.
Well, the Tigers are going to be forced to pick up some big yardage here. It's going to be 15 yards.
No, it's not. It's five if they take
right,
it.
Right, 15 yards for the first down, though.
They turn it down.
So third down and 10.
Sets up a third down and 10 from the 40.
Well, I know what Jim Hess is doing.
disagree with it, why give them three shots at 15 yards? You got two shots at 10 yards here. 5:08 to go in the game. Aggies lead the Tigers 39-31. It's a shootout. Three wides in the game again. Grambley with time. Looking.
Bowers
looking
deep.
Underneath to Abdullah. He's hit. And he lunges forward to the 30. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, but they're going to go for it here. Less than a yard to go.
Got to.
Great effort by Abdullah.
Boy, he had Bowers on the post for
did
six.
Yeah,
he did.
I think he looked at him and changed his mind. Didn't think he had him.
Tigers take a timeout.
And we will, too. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
base defense, which would.
Well, they gave him a new formation, didn't they?
Yeah, and they ran a counter away from all the strength. Pretty good play call by New Mexico State. So now they take the ball out of Ledbetter's hands. They're going back to man.
Second and eight. Now watch this formation again. Let's see if they do it again. Yeah, two tight wings, so it's a trips to the wide side. Man stays in. They haven't showed this formation all game. Going to give the ball to man. He breaks across the grain, and he's all the way out to the 35-yard line. A gain of nine more.
Great effort by man.
Oh, yeah, but it got to come up and got to play man on man and make some plays right here.
Yeah, you're out of your base defense given the formation they're giving you, and clearly that's not the answer for Pacific because New Mexico State just picked up two big first downs.
3:45 and counting. Can the Tigers do it again, two weekends in a row.
Now New Mexico State will take as much time off the clock as they can. They don't break the huddle until there's 11 seconds left on the
And again, look at this formation. Trips, but really with two tight ends also. They're going to get the ball to Mans. Sean Duncan for the loss. Back to the 31-yard line. Tigers with only two timeouts here. They took one before that fourth down play.
Huh. Duncan wrapped him up like a rag doll and threw him down.
Yeah, he guessed. He jumped through.
Only the second time today that Mans has lost yards on a carry.
Wow.
He's got to be right around the 200 mark.
Yeah, he is. They're using the clock. Two timeouts left.
Well, you got to be careful when you take them. You got to save something for your offense, too.
Not. I think you use them on defense.
Well, here's this formation again. Two tight ends. They're going to do something tricky out of this yet. You watch. Mans, he's hit behind the line. He'll lose again. Maybe another yard back to the 31.
Take it here or not?
Yeah, absolutely. You have control of the clock on offense. You don't on defense.
Chuck says no. I'll tell you why. He's thinking about if you got to bring a field goal kicker on.
Third down and 13 yards to go for the first down. This is the biggest third down game, unquestionably, of this third down play of the football game.
These last 5 minutes, anyway. Yeah, We had about 10 of these in the second half. All right, now standard formation. Tigers got to get out there. Ledbetter will quick snap this ball if he can. Third 13, Ledbetter sets up. He's got time. He's got Mans.
No.
Grudel falls down, 40, 45. He hurdles over Brian McGinnis, and it's a first down at the Tigers' 45-yard line. Grudel falls down. McGinnis ducks his head, and Mans makes the play with 1:48 left.
What a great
individual
effort.
They had it covered.
Yep, they sure as heck did. Man was a better player on that play.
Third and 13. The Aggies pick up 19 and 5, 24 on the play.
Wow, what a play. They had the swing pass covered.
Minute 38 to go in the game, and clock is running. Now minute 35.
Well, they can't do any good anyway to take it right now. You only got two timeouts. Play action fake. Ledbetter wants to scramble. Making pain. He does it. 40. He's down to the 35-yard line.
First down, Bob. Another first down.
Wow.
Tigers all of a sudden are on ice skates.
Yeah.
Can't get their footing.
Oh, jeez. 1:15 to go.
New Mexico State comes out in a smash mouth type formation through the whole series and gets it done offensively.
Now the Tigers take a timeout. We will too. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
just inside the Tiger 34-yard line.
Gotta try to strip the ball at this point.
Gonna give the ball to Manns. No, he keeps it. Ledbetter wants to roll outside. He's hit from the backside. He'll gain maybe a yard, but runs off time. Tigers take a timeout again with 1:04. We'll keep it right here. Remember, volleyball tonight at the Spanos Center. The 18th, we've got Dave Brubeck at the Faye Spanos Concert Theater, right. Concert Hall.
Tigers are out of timeouts now.
Yes.
Yeah, that's
the last
timeout.
They took the one on the
right.
Fourth down.
Right.
And the Nevada Wolfpack coming in next Saturday. They won on a squeaker at Logan, Utah against the Aggies, 30-25. That'll be a 1:30 kickoff, guys, a half hour earlier as we move later in the year. Tigers with a valiant effort here in the second half, but they dug themselves too deep a hole, Kurt Heinrich, in that first half, just playing very poorly.
Yeah, they really did. They gave up too much on the scoreboard to battle back. Although they almost did it.
They were outscored 29-3 in the first half, came back to outscore the Aggies so far 34-10 in this half.
Well, the Tigers have scored every time they've had the ball here in the second half, plus once when they didn't have the ball on a safety.
Well, it comes down to missing a PAT and missing a two-point conversions.
Is that correct?
Yep.
Yes.
So the Aggies with a 2nd and 10.
Can pretty much run it out.
Yeah, they can.
Yeah.
Because you can't stop the clock. They're not going to go out of bounds.
Ledbetter, quarterback sneak. That's all he's got to do. And the Tigers can't stop the clock. So the Tigers will turn to the role of spoiler. It's up to the Wolfpack and Northern Illinois to see who goes to the Las Vegas Bowl.
As the crowd begins to realize that this is history, 36 seconds left on the clock. Mexico State will come out of that huddle, but only one more play will have to be snapped before it's all over.
Well, we saw two different games tonight, two for the price of one.
What do you think about offensive and defensive players of the game, guys?
Well, Joe Abdullah, beyond a doubt, offensively.
Yeah, I would agree.
Grambley had a whale of a game, too.
Abdullah, once again, I would say, how about on defense? Anybody?
I don't know. Nobody comes to mind. We'll talk about it. We'll be back. That's
right.
It. As time runs out here, the final score, once again, to Mexico State, 39. The Tigers all the way back to 37. Couldn't get over the